Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Marcy. If you are new here, thank you for clicking on that thumbnail. If you are a returning subscriber, I thank you for always showing your girl some love and support. Please follow me on Instagram. It's Marcemellow, M-A-R-C-E-M-E-L-L-0-W. And I'm pretty sure all of you all have that in your head, especially the way that I say it. Y'all, everybody, today is an amazing day. Not only is it an amazing Saturday, but I've been waiting for this fragrance for about a week now, and I'm just so excited to have it. It just arrived this morning, and y'all know I love doing unboxes with the crew, right? Yes, I call you guys my YouTube crew, my YouTube family, and I'm super excited. Today, we're going to unbox the amazing house of BDK Velvet Tonka. It is finally here, and I'm so excited to add this to my other 6 BDK fragrances. I absolutely love the house of BDK, Passé Soir, Gris Charnel, Rouge Smoking, like all of it, such amazing fragrances, and excited to be able to add this one to the collection. So I was so excited when I heard about it and when I saw it, because I'm like, BDK, the closest they have to a gourmand, and you know I'm such a gourmand girl, is Rouge Smoking. Even though I like Gris Charnel, it's like there's a little bit of bittersweetness to that. It's not a gourmand. Rouge Smoking is the sweetest one that they have. So I was like, BDK needs a gourmand, and here it is. Supposedly Velvet Tonka. I'm not quite sure yet, but I'm gonna let you know in just a moment. So this has amazing notes. When I saw the notes, you know I'm the blind buy queen, right? I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna purchase the big bottle, because if I like it and it's sold out, I'm gonna be really upset with myself. And then the notes of orange blossom, ladies, gentlemen, we all love vanilla, tonka bean, we all love. So y'all, without further ado, let's get into this BDK fragrance, new BDK fragrance, Velvet Tonka. But first, let me read you a little bit of story. They don't really have any characters in this story like they do most of their other fragrances, like Passé Soir, when the lady's like, not tonight, boo, not tonight. So this one, they just give you a little bit of background on the fragrance and pretty much where it started. So I'm gonna read you the passage that they wrote on their website, okay? So excited, you all. I hope you all are as excited as I am. This is an amazing day. So the story goes, tonka bean is an ingredient full of contrast, sometimes reminiscent of vanilla leather, sometimes almond, sometimes even chocolatey facets. Velvet Tonka is characterized by its trilogy of tonka beans, orange blossom, and almonds. When worn on the skin, it coats it like an oriental delicacy dusted in icing sugar. Doesn't that sound amazing? The balmy tonka bean is adorned with almonds and rose petals for a velvety touch, and with hints of tobacco absolute to give it a honeyed feel. Can you just visualize all of that in your head? Deliciousness. It sounds like sticky, right? Yeah. It says, in the base, addictive notes of milky amyris and amyris wood unfurl, enhanced by ambroxan and vanilla absolute for an unparalleled velvetiness and sensuality. Velvet Tonka is a tribute to the Moroccan origins, indulgent of the breeze coming straight from the Atlas Mountains. You all know that I've been to Morocco. I spent 28 days over there. We had to cross through the Atlas Mountains in order for me to get to the Sahara Desert. I spent 3 days in the camping in the Sahara Desert. When I tell you the Atlas Mountains, it's an amazing sight to see. You see all the homes in the Atlas Mountains. They're pretty much, it's like, red dusty brick everywhere. Everything is like a brownish red color. I'll post some pictures when I actually post the Velvet Tonka, and some pictures of me in the Sahara Desert. Also, I have a Sahara Desert highlight on my Instagram as well. That was the most amazing experience for me. You know, just the fact that, you know, this this young black girl stuck her feet in the Sahara Desert sand was like the one of the most amazing moments. And I don't know why I'm getting all emotional. But anyway, this is about fragrances, y'all. So anyway, I've had amazing travels, and just to relate them to some of these fragrances is just absolutely amazing, y'all. And that experience to me alone was the most amazing experience and so heartfelt. You know, I ended up planning the trip. I plan all of my trips all by myself, y'all. I just pretty much do a lot of research, and I just get on YouTube. I get on Expedia, TripAdvisor. And I just started doing research, and I basically plan my trips myself, you know, how to navigate through other countries and everything. So just being, I think I've only used a travel agent one time, and it was for like a girls trip because it was a group thing. But other than that, you know, I planned every single one of my trips. You know, I'm not a trip planner, or, you know, but I can give you a little bit of advice. You know, I don't even have itineraries written down. You know, I just basically put everything in my phone and I go. But just knowing that this was inspired, and it's a tribute to Morocco and the Atlas Mountains, this fragrance basically touched my heart. And every time I see this fragrance, I am going to think of Morocco and the Atlas Mountains and the 16 hours that it took us driving through the Atlas Mountains to get to the Sahara Desert. But anyway, okay. There's always some drama over here on this camera, y'all. But anyway, the Atlas Mountains, if you could look it up, you know, the internet really does no justice to it, but just to be there in that 100 degree heat, and all you see are just like, you know, homes being built by people, and, you know, basically the Berber people, just to be able to sit down and have tea with them, you know, see them washing clothes in the river. You know, they have certain traditions and foods, and, you know, chicken tagine is good, you know, and the couscous and all of that. Oh my gosh, it completely takes me back, and this fragrance is definitely gonna take me back. So this is the box. So anyway, I'm gonna post some pictures even prior to this review and on my Instagram. I'm just so, so excited. So it actually comes, you know, all top secret looking. You know, I ordered this from the site, from BDK site. So yeah, let's open this up. Let's open this baby up and let's get into the fragrance. I couldn't sleep thinking about this fragrance. I'm like, you know what? It's been usually BDK. They're very fast when it comes to shipping their fragrances. So it was, I ordered it, I think like 8 days ago, 8-9 days ago. It just so happened, I actually didn't even know that they were coming out with a fragrance, a new fragrance. And then all of a sudden I opened my Instagram and boom, there it was. So it was meant for me to have, y'all. So, cause I would have never gone, I follow BDK, but you know, based on the algorithm, you get so many, fragrance, sites that sometimes BDK doesn't pop up. So here it is. You know, BDK, they have stunning boxes. You know, it comes with this really nice, they always send this card, you know. It says, thank you. It says, dear Marcelina, thank you so much for your order. We hope that you will enjoy discovering our new creation of Velvet Tonka. Kind regards, BDK Parfum. So they always send these beautiful cards. And this is just an editorial about the BDK company. It always comes with all this. I always keep this stuff too. The cute wrapping. So yeah, let's unbox. And this is just going to go on the floor for now. Ooh. So isn't this a delicious looking box? So my Citrus Riviera came in a blue box. One came in a black box, I think, and the other one, I can't remember, I think it might have been Gris Charnel, and the other one comes in like a creamy colored white box with black writing on it. This one, I'm so glad they changed the color box. This is a beautiful, beautiful color box. I think this is like a mauve pink color, you know? Beautiful. It also came with a sample of Velvet Tonka. And it lists, of course it's French, and it lists the actual notes on the front of the box, you know, which is basically rose absolute. You got some absolute tobacco, you have tonka bean, you have some vanilla, you have amyris, you have amber, you have orange blossom. So y'all, let's get into what this fragrance is all about. This fragrance means so much more to me today since I found out the origin and where it came from, because it completely takes me back. This is nostalgic as well, y'all. Every time I see this, Morocco. All right, comes in this beautiful bottle. Almost reminds you of the tuberose fragrance. But the tuberose has more of a matte top and the juice is a little more orange. It's a slightly more orange, yeah. Beautiful bottles. I like all of their bottles are really similar, but different at the same time. So, and it actually matches what I have on today. You know, I didn't know what color. I just so happen to put on this color. You all know that I love bright colors, right? So let's get into it. I'm gonna stop talking. So this is gonna be my scent of the day. BDK's fragrances, they usually last, they're like in the mid-range as far as like performance, you know, and lasting power. So even if this lasts 4 or 6 hours, I'm good with that. So let's go ahead and spray. Atlas Mountains. We're spraying everywhere. This is good. Yes, I'm going to overspray. Overspray. I get powderiness, you know. I think I sprayed enough on my hand. It's so smooth. I don't get any alcohol or any harsh notes. I do get the orange blossom. Definitely the orange blossom. This is so smooth. I absolutely love it. This is the all year long fragrance. Definitely spring, summer. The orange blossom, the vanilla, the tonka bean. I don't get any rose yet. But I get a lot of creaminess in this fragrance. This is a stunning fragrance. This is very smooth, you know? Slightly sweet, but not too sweet, but definitely like a sort of like a vanilla gourmand. But you smell more of the creaminess from the tonka bean than actual vanilla. Slight smoke, very, very slight smokiness. Nothing like, you know, the smokiness and the bitterness of Feb Delicious or Mason Margiela by the fireplace, but it's a really, I'm getting a slight floral note. I'm not even looking at the camera because I'm so concentrated on the fragrance, y'all. Definitely very smooth, very creamy. In the opening, I got a burst of orange blossom, but now I'm getting smooth, creamy tonka bean with a hint of smokiness. And I think the smokiness may be coming from, the tobacco, maybe, or that tonka bean. You're getting like a really, I don't know, it's like a, almost like a soft white leather. Yeah, not a harsh dark leather, and not a new leather either, because when you smell new leather, you know, I smell new leather. I went to a over in Morocco. I can't even think of the name. But there's a place where they actually make leather, you know, and they dye the leather. And, you know, they do all those things. So it's not a fresh leather, because fresh leather smells foul. I even have to put mint over my nose as I walk through. So this smells like a really clean, refined, like a slight, super soft, maybe like a lamb skin or something, and the undertone, but I do get a slight, really slight, because I really don't like leather and fragrances, but I do get something in here that's reminiscent of slight smokiness and maybe a little bit of like a leathery suede smell. Kind of like a reminiscent of a Rosendo Mateau number 5. It has that really soft, smooth, silky, suedey smell. Suede smell. You know, it's drying down very, very soft, so I can imagine myself definitely overspraying this, you know? But it sits really close to the skin. I'm not saying it's a skin scent, but right now it's really close to my skin. But I'm getting that nuttiness, the almondy, you know, as it dries down, I'm getting more almondy tonka bean. That orange blossom, I'm not getting so much, you know? But maybe if I sprayed it on my clothes, it might maintain the orange blossom. But yeah. This is really, I really, really like this. This is so smooth. It leaves a little bit of a sheen. Yes, I'm spraying again. You know, just to give you guys and me an amazing scent today. Yes, like I said, in the opening, you get that orange blossom, you get the sweetness, the vanilla, and then as it dries down, you're getting that almondy, slight suedey, very smooth though, suede leathery smell, but you're still getting that tonka bean as well. Still getting the orange blossom. Absolutely love this. This is a very, I made this review long. Actually, it was gonna be like a 10 minute review by talking about all of my travels, but like I said, this fragrance, I absolutely love it. I can't really speak to the performance on it yet, but usually, like I said, BDK's fragrances are not beast mode in performance, which is okay because sometimes I don't like smelling like certain things all day long. Rouge smoking, I definitely overspray. Grease Charnel. Now, Tuberose Imperial, I take that back. Tuberose Imperial is beast mode, okay? But my other ones are definitely moderate performance, moderate projection, you know, sillage is good, you know. But yeah, I love this. It's very soft, you know, but like I said, I'm going to spray it on my clothes. You know, I'm going to wear this for the day and then I'll come back later or on another review and give you all like an update. Or also on Instagram and give you an update on how I feel about the performance of this fragrance. But off top, up front, I actually really, really love this fragrance. It leans gourmand-ish, but I still wouldn't consider this like a super gourmand. It's nothing sweet like Killian Love Don't Be Shy, Guimauve, you know, any of that. Flower Bomb, none of that. None of those creamy fragrances. Absolutely not that sweet, but I guess this is a unisex fragrance, so you know they have to make it appealing to both men and women and whomever, you know. So they, you know, this crosses all gender lines. But definitely, I'm so excited about Velvet Tonka. Definitely love this. First impressions, you got it from me. You know, I'm so excited to be able to share this with you all. Get your nose. I mean, I don't see any disappointment or anybody being disappointed in this fragrance. So get your nose, even if you have to order the 10 ml testers, they have those as well. I think they're about $30, $40. You can order those on the site. You know, I blind buy everything pretty much, but I just started ordering from Max Aroma, the samples, and I absolutely love that, but I'm so glad that I bought the big bottle of this. You can definitely use this. You know what this will be stunning with? This will be amazing to layer with Rouge Smoking. That orange blossom, the tonka bean, the velvetiness of this, the almond on top of the cherry, almond, milky, creamy scent of Rouge Smoking, a match made in heaven, y'all. Delicious. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna wear this today, but then I'll wear Rouge Smoking and tonka bean mix tomorrow. This would also be great with tuberose imperial. You know, tuberose imperial is really kind of like striking and not too abrasive, but it's pretty much in your face. This might add a little bit of creaminess to tuberose imperial, because you really get a lot of tuberose in that, a lot of white florals and tuberose in that fragrance. So this will add an amazing and stunning creaminess. Gris Charnel, not so much. Citrus Riviera, not so much. But the other ones, Rouge Smoking and Tuberose Imperial, definitely amazing. All right, that concludes my amazing review on this beautiful fragrance. And BDK, I absolutely love the color of the box, you know. Love, love, love this, you all. Get your nose on it. And I thank you for watching my unboxing and review of this amazing, amazing house of BDK. Absolutely love their fragrances. Bye-bye, y'all.